church, get born again, get baptized, do drugs. Come to church, get refreshed, go do drugs. And the cycle just repeats itself over and over again until you get to the point where I can't take this anymore. Why don't you tell us what's going on, Ricky?
You know, so today I have a couple months of sobriety in my life, and it's real. I came to church one Sunday morning, and Josh preached a message on producing spiritual fruit, eh? And the message really hit me. You know, he talked about accepting Christ and the seeds planted, eh? And then he started drawing these sprouts on the seed and talking about, you know, you get baptized, you go to encounter God meeting, you go to corporate prayer meetings, all this stuff that I was doing, eh? And I realized that the message was for me, and I made a decision to go to rehab. And I went to Brentwood once before, eh? And I realized that, you know, there's things in my heart that hinder me, you know, and all these things that have happened in my past life, and they make me run to the drugs and alcohol, eh? You know, so I made a decision to go to rehab, and I get there, and the thing I learned last time I was there, that I could get in with the other alcoholic, you know, the other addict, and I could share, and I could share freely and not be judged, and I can get the freedom I'm looking for, you know. And so I get there and I start sharing God with people, eh? And at first they thought it was this big front, you know, and then I started sharing on how I came to God and how I met Pastor Josh. You know, and I ended up going to jail, and I died of a drug overdose, and they ended up saving my life, you know, and after that happened, I went back to the range, and I was getting my meds from a nurse, and she said that I was lucky to be alive, and I said, how lucky, and I was kind of laughing, and she said, you should be thanking God, you know, and it hit me really hard. You know, it hit me really hard, and I get out of jail, and I asked Josh. I said, I want to follow up with you and come to church. And you know, I came to church, and you know, I was accepted for who I was, and I wanted to give that back, eh? So I, you know, I started, when I got baptized, God spoke to me and He said to bring my people, eh? Bring the addicts and the suffering, you know. And I did that, eh? And I started sharing Christ with people, but I was still in bondage, eh? And then I went to rehab, and, you know, I started to share my life with people.
Yeah.
You know, and they helped me realize who I was in the flesh, you know, and how when I was in bondage, I wasn't such a good person, eh? And so I started sharing and caring with people, and they started sharing and caring with me, you know, and I got the freedom, eh? You know, and I started really talking to people about God, you know, and they started calling me Reverend Ricky, you know, and I just started, you know, I just told people my experience, you know, and how I came with God, to God, and how God healed my mom of an assist, you know, all this stuff, eh, and I ended up praying with a couple people to accept Christ, and this journey has just been amazing. You know, I just want to really thank the church. You know, I'm really honored to be a part of this church. You know, this church has done so much for me in my walk with God. You know, and I really believe that I've been healed. I really truly believe that today. You know, and you know, the solution to my problem was people, eh? When I was 3 years old, you know, my mom left my father, and I closed up, eh? And I thought, you know, I'm never going to get hurt again. You know, and I was living with this closed heart. And when I went to Brentwood, I realized that, eh? And it's like, how do you live spiritually? Well, you live from the heart. You know, and I realized that the longest journey is from the head to the heart. Eh? I was living my whole life in my head. You know, and I accept Christ, and He opened my heart just a little bit, eh? And I started getting in with people, and it was just amazing. People are the solution to my problem, eh? You know, I go to this program, and the program runs on, it's an ask, listen, and do as you're told program. They bring you right down to when you're a kid, eh? And there's nothing that you can do there without asking, you know, and here I got to go and I got to ask for everything, and that was a struggle, eh? And I just got in with people and my heart was open, and today I feel amazing, eh? I really do, you know, and this journey is going to continue.
Yeah.
You know, it really is, you know, I'm just so happy that Christ is the center of my life. You know, Christ is, He changed my life. He really did, eh? You know, and I just really want to thank the church.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
And so there's people who want to encourage you and who want to bring you up to a better place. And then there's people who want to tear you down and people who want to kill you. And they don't always know it. They don't always know it. They think they're being your friend. Hey, man, let's go party. Hey, Ricky, come on, let's do some, you know? And they don't realize that the enemy is using them to bring death. But Jesus comes and brings life. He brings life.
Yeah.
You're not the same person that you used to be. And God says, I'm going to take all that hurt and all that pain, and I'm going to turn around, and I'm going to use it for good in the kingdom so that many souls will be saved.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise Jesus.